Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, to episode 2 of the Plants vs. Zombies 2 Garden Warfare, excuse me, I got that in the wrong order, of the Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2 campaign. Now, I'm gonna warn you full on that is a, heck of a mouthful, so I'm probably just gonna be calling it the PVZ GW2 campaign for future episodes. So, yeah, our work isn't done yet. The apocalypse waits for no one. And we are going to be going into a mission where there's gonna be a lot of them like it, where we're not going to be alone. Kind of like with this little weed here, sometimes you'll have allies in your mission. But before we get into that mission proper, there are still a few other things to show you. Because you will have pots like the sunflower up there, and a few other things like the scaredy shroom that we had in the beginning of our last episode. Now, most of our allies will be a little more helpful than the scaredy shroom, let me tell you. But I feel like now is a good time to show you the sticker shop. Now, if you're not like me, and you haven't been playing this game for years, you're going to have a few things other than the Minions booster packs. There will be quite a few packs that will let you get helpful items and a few customizations. There's one pack in particular called the Spectacular Character Pack that you'll have, as long as you haven't bought all the characters like me, that will just straight up get you another character variant, which I'll probably cover most of those later on. But for now, we're gonna grab a Minions booster pack, as most of these things that you can get from here are actually gonna be helpful for the next mission. So yeah, there is actually a use to your coins. Yeah, helpful stuff. You know, the heal flower might come in handy. Although, the character we're playing as can give you those for free, but we'll cover that in a few moments. There's also another way to get your coins ripped away from you, and that is with rucks. Now, again, if you're not like me, and you know, you don't own half the items in a shop, every once in a while he'll sell you a few useful abilities. A lot of them are ungodly expensive, but are very good alternatives. And I'll probably cover all the abilities that rucks can sell in a future episode. Now, without further ado, I feel like, well, there is one more thing I should show you, the quest board. So, in addition to the assignments that DaveBot 3000 gives you, every once in a while you'll find a few quests here on the board that are, you know, certain specific tasks, like, you know, stun 25 zombies with Citrine's EM Peach, and other miscellaneous tasks. Every once in a while, it can be good to come here and check, as you may actually complete a lot of these just going through the campaign. And they give you stars, which are a sort of secondary currency that you can use to open up certain chests that are hidden throughout the backyard. I wish I could actually show you one though, because I've played this game way too long and I'm pretty sure I've opened up all of them. So let's talk about the character that I'm playing as next before we get into the mission. So this is the Sunflower. So the main selling point of Sunflower is that she can heal. In fact, she has quite a few abilities for healing. She can, you know, attach that heal beam, so if there are any allies around you that have been wounded, you can use that to get them back into shape. She also can spawn a heal pot, just a healing flower, just wherever you decide. Absolutely free. It doesn't cost you any resources other than its cooldown. Now, these do go away after a while, but some momentary healing is always a good thing. And yeah, she also has a sunbeam, which does... yeah, that. Safe to say, anything that gets hit by this for too long is not going to stay in the fight. And yeah, that's Sunflower's abilities. Her main weapon is the Sun Pulse, which, it's a pretty nice rapid-fire weapon. The projectile is quite small in width, so it can be a little hard to hit things, unlike with the pea shooter. But if you can hit a target consistently, you can probably take them down pretty quick. So, yeah, without further ado, let's get into our next mission. Hello there, DaveBot3000. What do you have for us today? So, yes, this will be a special ops mission. These are basically missions where you will be occupying a certain area, usually defending a garden, and also trying to stick around in the area and stay alive to complete a certain task. Now, usually the situation will bring the party to you, so defense in depth is very helpful here. So, yeah, let's just get into it. Now, I will be doing special ops missions like this on normal difficulty, because most of these missions are already very hard, and it's still not on easy difficulty, so if you're on easy difficulty, you'll have a technically easier time than me. So, yeah, let's just get started before I yammer on longer than the actual mission takes. Alright, it's time to demonstrate skill 2, specifically your ability to remove sand from shoes. Crazy Dave wrote his master plan for how to defeat Zomboss on the inside of his shoes. But then, his shoes got wet. So, he left his shoes to dry by the volcano on Boney Island, a strategically unwise decision. Now the zombies have stolen his shoes, and we need to get them back. Resume looking busy. Alright, bring on the sand. Alright, Boney Island. Interesting, it's asking me if I've ever seen a singularity up close. I actually haven't. I have never indulged in singularity watching, unfortunately. I'm very sad about it. But, yeah, let's get into it. Oh yeah, I guess you technically haven't seen this yet. But yeah, this is your main character select menu. Which, when you're in this menu, you can basically go to any of the characters you've unlocked and customize them with any abilities you've gotten or character upgrades that you've gotten from leveling up. As, yeah, you can level up your characters and slowly get certain upgrades for them down in the character upgrade section. Now, I won't be having any of these applied because when you're first starting out, you won't have any of them. So I figure I'll just go through the whole campaign without them just to be the most helpful. So anyway, we're gonna be doing this as Sunflower, as she's going to be very helpful for this mission. Alright. Kind of a cool looking area, gotta admit. That shoe thief is around here. Well, I would hope you dropped me off near him. So yeah, we will need to be planting a garden before he shows up. So, grow, plant, hero. So, in these special ops missions, then you will have the option to grow other playable characters that will come along and help you. And, yeah, sometimes their AI isn't the best. They can, get themselves killed pretty fast, I have to admit. But they are pretty competent 90% of the time. Now, I'm just going to be growing base characters here since, you know, you probably won't have most of the variants unlocked by this point. So, let's bring in a Sunflower. Now, it does actually show you what their AI is going to be prioritizing. So here it shows, Sunflower will prioritize staying near teammates, keeping them healed and in the fight. So, yeah, that's gonna be helpful. Oh yeah, and they will also have whatever character upgrades and customizations you have applied to them. Gonna be kinda weird having a twin clone of me running around, but okay. And yeah, let's bring in a pea shooter. It's one of those, you know, they're always good damage dealers and quite versatile. Yeah, here on the AI it says, Pea Shooter is fast and mobile and will actively engage zombies throughout the map. So, yeah, basically he's just always going to be running around being helpful. Now, the good thing is the AI isn't stupid. They will actually try to retreat back if they start getting into danger. Now, I'm not sure if you saw it, but it did actually say, your enemies grow stronger. Yeah, they will actually spawn in more enemies to compensate for everything you spawned in, but believe me, in my experience, at least, it's always more helpful to have allies with you rather than not, as usually they can outperform the extra enemies. So, yeah, now we'll just plant the garden itself. So basically, we'll be needing to keep this thing alive while searching for, in this case, Crazy Dave's shoes. Alright, now let's grow some plant defenses. Yeah, so those minions booster packs will give you some of these plants that you can plop down. Now, I've kind of already gone over a lot of this in the first episode, but you know, I feel like I should kind of tell you, you know, things like scaredy shrooms are very good at long-ranged combat, however that's not very useful for this map, and scaredy shroom will also hide if zombies get close. Gatling pea is a very nice rapid-fire weapon that can deal some very good damage, so pretty nice to have those around. Alright, now we got some zombies. Oh yeah, and exploding imp fans. Yeah, these guys will try to get onto you and explode. And the damage is, the damage they deal is not so modest when they blow up, let's just say that. Alright, oh, it was a perfect wave. Yeah, if you don't have the garden take any damage, then you'll actually get a few more coins. Alright then. Oh yeah, I'm pretty good at this stuff. Well, you know, I wouldn't be making videos teaching people how to play the game if I wasn't good at the game. Yeah, this is a sunbeam moment. Sunbeam is very useful in large crowds like this. Oh, we got some foot soldiers. Ooh, okay. Now, there are different classifications of zombies, like these brown coats are considered just normal zombies, but the foot soldiers are actually considered hero zombies. So they generally have better AI, and you know, like I've said in the last episode, foot soldier has a lot of nice abilities he can use to completely mess you up. You know, he's got the smoke grenades, the ZPG, which he almost tried to hit me with, and even jetpacks. I think that may have been another perfect wave. And there are also boss zombies, which, well, we've already met one of those, the Giga Gargantuar. Oh, zombie Girl Scouts? Yeah, that's gonna be a bit of a situation. I'm willing to bet they aren't bringing cookies. Now, most of the special ops missions will last for about 3 to 5 waves. Good god, he almost fell in the water. Oh, hello, flag zombies. Yeah, this is another type of brown coat. Oh, good god, there's lots of them. Basically, the flag zombies, they run around, and any zombie around them with white sparkles has a sort of armor buff, which means that they will be taking far less damage. And yeah, it's really annoying when they're in crowds like this and it's just a stacking armor buff. Oh dear, our first engineer. Yeah, the engineer is a very annoying zombie. Good god, he died so fast I can't really explain him. Basically, engineers are very good at dealing damage to you. They also have a bit of splash like pea shooter. Oh, there's a Gargantua. So he's got the shoes. Good. Not a Giga Gargantua, just a Gargantua. But yeah, the engineer has a stun, and he also has the jackhammer. His stun is pretty nasty on the engineer, as it keeps you stunned for a good few seconds, and that's time that a lot of zombies can just absolutely shred you to bits. And his jackhammer means he gets into the fray a lot faster. Okay. Oh dear. Yeah, see, now I'm dealing less damage because that freaking flag zombie walked by. Uh-oh. Ooh, the AI sunflower's looking a little low on health. No, get the heal meme on her, thank you. There we go, we will be a sunflower pair. Yeah, this is actually a pretty effective strategy to just stick by a sunflower and just have you two heal each other. A lot of people find it really annoying. I think it's just clever strategy. That's what I think. Oof. Alright, we got the secret plan shoes. Now let's clean up any other stragglers. Like the newspaper. Alrighty then. I'd say that went pretty smoothly, all things considered. Garble Marble, you did it! Yep, we did. Let's get out of here. Bring the shoes. Oh, absolutely. Alright then. And now we're out of here. Mission complete. And we got another 5,000 coins. Pretty nice, I say. So, yeah, that was the Secret Plan's Shoes mission. Now, I will be going into each of the plant characters more in-depth in separate videos. Like, you know, some characters have funny strategies like that twin sunflower combination where you two just heal each other. But I feel like that would just stretch these videos out really long, and this one is already, like, I think around 17 minutes, probably more like 18. I lose track of time when doing these. Anyway, before I go, I have to say that if you could consider liking the video if you enjoyed it and found it helpful, and even subscribing or commenting, I would find that so helpful, as I have absolute buckets upon buckets of viewers. Viewers that could be subscribers. I'm just saying, it's just one click away, it's right there, it's not that hard. But anyway, I hope you have a good day, and I will see you in the next mission.